So for as long as I can remember, I've been a spiritual person. I think it was about maybe around like time I was 10 or 9 maybe. I was obsessed with nature and I was in love with willow trees, and I still am in love with willow trees. They're my favorite trees. When I would see a snake, I wouldn't be afraid. I would just kind of be that weirdo that would like want to seek it out, I suppose. And that sounds strange saying that, even to me, even for me. I was never like afraid of anything. And I felt connected to everything. And I think that I was about 11 or 12 or something when I started listening to meditation music. I was so drawn to the sounds of meditation music. I just loved it. I adored it. I listened to it every day. And I'm not I really did listen to it every day. And I think that when I was 13, I don't know how I did this, but I diagnosed myself with depression. I had no idea what depression was, what it meant. And that's the kookiest part. But now I'm just kind of like reflecting back on other things, other aspects in my life that just made me feel like there's something wrong with me. There's something seriously wrong with me. But like, for instance, I would always feel the need to be alone instead of being with people. I was antisocial. And I never really knew where it came from, because it's not like I was an introvert. I wasn't an introvert because I had no problem talking to people. I just, I didn't get any kind of anxiety from talking to people. I didn't get any anxiety from mingling. I tried to mingle, but a lot of people kind of rejected me because I was seen as the weird kid. And, you know, those are just high school days. People are like just kids, whatever. I've always felt the need to like be the odd one out. And it never really made sense to me why. And honestly, I think that astrology really helped me understand myself in that aspect. It helped me understand myself because of looking at my chart and seeing why am I the way that I am. But honestly, I think other things that helped me understand myself is the spiritual path. Last year I ran into some hard times, lost a couple of friends, it was bad. But I'd spent so much time alone, and in that time alone, I discovered myself. I realized that I'm avoiding who I truly am. And that's why I was so sad. I'm ignoring who I am, trying to pretend to be something that I'm not. Somebody that I'm not, sorry. And I guess that, having that realization, it's done so much for me. I'm not depressed anymore. I'm not sad about anything these days. I'm not an angry person these days. And I feel more connected to things that, I feel more connected to things that I was connected to as a child. I loved nature. I loved meditation music. Even as I was kind of sliding into being somebody that I wasn't, those things were still not a part of, like, those things I was starting to forget. I was starting to forget those things that I loved as a child. And I didn't want to be in nature, you know? I didn't want to be outside for too long, unless it was the summertime. I was slowly starting to forget who I truly am to my core. I feel like we forget who we truly are sometimes. We forget how connected we are. We get so caught up in our day-to-day lives. And we become consumed with selfishness, greed, just our own baggage, our own shit, honestly. And like, I'm not saying that I never do. I'm not perfect. I do too. But we just really, we're not grasping how beautiful everything truly is around us. Everything is so beautiful, and everybody is miserable, and everybody is getting in touch with the lower aspects of themselves, and it's just, it's such a waste. When you see something as beautiful as this place, when you see something as beautiful as nature, where I am right now, for instance, and you hear the birds, and you see the trees, and you see the water, and you feel the air, and you feel the sun on your skin, these are all the four elements of nature. Earth, air, fire, water. Fire being the sun, of course. Earth being the rocks. The air, the wind. And the water being that lake. If we spent more time here, and I know it sounds like such a typical hippie thing to say, but honestly, it's just such a human thing to say in my perspective. We spent even like a couple of hours every day getting in touch with this place, places like, getting in touch with places such as this. I think it would change. Maybe it would change, at least a little bit, how we see reality, how we see the world. Other things have to be done, of course. Changing your mindset, for instance, changing your routine, listening to meditation music. And all these things that people don't even see, that they somewhat take for granted, it's right here. It's the most simplest of ways to be happy. Feel connected to everything. yeah. I don't know what else to say. I don't know what the point of this is. It's just, I felt like talking about this, I suppose. But either way, I hope you guys are having a good day or night. Love, peace, and harmony. Bye.